of my message today is transforming your life by trusting God. Transforming your life by trusting God. And my supportive scripture is coming from Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 through 12. And it reads, "Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. Be not wise in thine own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. It shall be health to thy navel and marrow to thy bones. Honor the Lord with thy substance and with the first fruits of all thine increase. So shall thy horns be filled with plenty, and thy presses shall burst out with new wine. My son, despise not the chastening of the Lord, neither be weary of his correction. For whom the Lord loveth, he correcteth, even as a father the son in whom he delighted." Please bow your heads. Dear God, as always, I'm coming to you once again to say thank you for yet another opportunity to speak on your behalf. I pray that this message will truly inspire someone today, as it has inspired me, Lord. Please, let it be clear to everyone who is present here today. Use me, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Trusting God is simply believing that he loves you, he's good, he has the power to help you, he wants to help you, and he will help you. Christians are called believers, but many times we are more like unbelieving Christians. We trust our friends. We trust the bank. We trust the stock market or the government more than we actually trust God and his word. In John chapter 15, verse 5, Jesus says that apart from him, we can do nothing. We need to lean on him for help with everything in our lives. Now, sadly, a lot of people go to church, hear about what they should do, and then they go home and try to do it on their own. They usually end up desperately telling God how hard they're trying to do what they're supposed to, but yet they're leaving him out. God wants us to put him first in our lives. He wants us to put our confidence and trust in him all the time and in everything. So don't depend on you. We live in a world where trust must be earned and seems to be in short supply. But Solomon, the famous king who wrote Proverbs, he knew that trust is exactly where we must start. Most of us have faced disappointments which have taught us that we can only depend upon ourselves. But living the life God has called us to means unlearning that lesson. Instead, we're meant to rest in God's understanding. Sometimes trusting God completely can be tough. We always want to help God out and tell him how to do things, when to do things, why to do it. So each day, we must lay aside our own plans and expectations and surrender to his plans. But what if we don't feel like we can trust him like that? Well, that's when we should cry out to God. Surrendering to God begins with our lips and our thoughts. We need more than a commitment to depend on him. We need to cry out to him to show that dependence. And when we pray, we admit that his ways are higher than ours. We show that we're leaving our troubles and burdens and dreams in his capable hands. In fact, the Bible promises that when we reach out to him in prayer, he hears us. We have handed the keys of our lives to God, and we know he's able to lead us. But in order for that to work, we have to run from evil. So much in this world can clutter up our relationship with God. John, the writer of the fourth gospel, describes them as the desires of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride in our lives. In other words, our blessings can easily become the stumbling blocks when we think of them as what we deserve or what we need to be happy. Instead, life works best, when we remember the true source of our blessing, who is God, and then focus on the things that please him. Now, sometimes the only way to live the life God wants us to live is by separating ourselves from the bad influences that keeps dragging us down. That works best when we start pursuing something else in its place. But is that easy? Not at all. Fleeing from the evil desires that pull at us means spending a lot of time crying out to God and leaning on him. But our Creator promises that he's going to honor our commitment to him when we shun evil. When we pursue him, we find life, abundant life. Running from evil and pursuing God doesn't come naturally to most of us. Instead, it means that we have to make a serious change. We must put God first in our lives. It's very easy to put ourselves first. And when something good happens, we always want to congratulate ourselves with a reward. When something bad happens, we want to console ourselves or find someone else to blame. And when it comes to money, the struggle is even harder. If we can trust God with the first of our wealth, we are truly showing how much we depend on him. Handing over the first part of our paycheck takes a huge amount of faith after all. But doing so means being God-centric. To get there, though, we have to make sure that we check ourselves by God's word. Now, let's be honest. We aren't so good at evaluating ourselves. We will go to great lengths to excuse our behavior, our actions, and our sins. So my question is, who needs a defense attorney when we can pretty much find a reason for every bad thing that we do? If we're ever going to truly trust in God and flee evil, we have to know exactly where we stand. We have to find an objective measure that tells us the truth. And that truth comes from God and his word. And of course, that doesn't mean we'll always like what we see and how we see it. Sometimes it takes something bad happening or seeing ourselves in a bad situation before we finally admit that we need to change. And the more we're in the Bible, the more likely this is to happen. When we have scripture planted firmly in our hearts, God will often use that to deal with us. So we must listen to the Holy Spirit. When Jesus promised to send the Holy Spirit to the church, he told his disciples that this counselor would be their spiritual compass, or GPS. And as we go through our day, this same Holy Spirit guides us too. That means we don't have to go at it alone or hope we're getting it right. The Holy Spirit leads us into all truth, and he protects us. After all, the gift of the Holy Spirit to us believers reminds us that we can truly rest in God's love. When we face a difficult world each day, we sometimes wonder if God even cares. Why do bad things happen? Where is God when I need him? Well, I have great news for you. God never takes a break or leaves us to fend for ourselves. Even in the midst of turmoil, the Las Vegas massacre, mudslides, hurricane, fires, flooding, death, divorce, little money, no money, job loss, sickness, pain, all of that, even in the midst of all of that, God sticks with us and uses those challenges to shape us. Excuse me. When we understand that, our perspective completely changes. No longer do we see our setbacks as failures. We see them as moments when God, as our loving Father, works on us. And that's exactly why we can trust in the Lord with all thine heart. He cares for each and every day. He cares for us. He gives us what we need to thrive. He pours blessing after blessing upon us. Trusting God takes a wholehearted commitment from dusk to dawn, but we're never alone in it. We have to habitually study the Word to really have confidence in God and know we can hear him. The Bible is food for our spirit. And as we spend time reading and meditating on scripture, we develop a strong spirit. Yes. Then we can hear God speaking to us, yes, to our heart, where he dwells in us, yes, and then make decisions based upon what he's leading us to do, not just what we may think, what we feel or want. And when we go beyond what we want, what we think, and what we feel, and do what the Word and the Spirit of God tells us to do, we are able to develop good habits and break the bad ones. We come to a place where the blessings of God, his righteousness, peace, and joy, it overflows in our lives. And as I come to a close, I just want to say that life is simple and peaceful when we go to God like little children and say, God, I don't want to live on my own. I want to trust you. When I don't know what to do, I want to trust you. When I don't understand why, Lord, I'll trust you. I'll do my part with your help. And when I'm done, I'll trust you to do the rest. Thank you. Thank you, and we praise you. It's in Jesus' name we pray.